The first is column drop. Column drop is probably the easiest. At its narrowest viewport, each element simply stacks vertically, one on top of the other. As things get wider, the elements expand until the first breakpoint is hit. At the first breakpoint, instead of having all the elements stacked, two elements are now side by side, and the third element is underneath. The elements keep expanding as the viewport gets wider until the next breakpoint is hit. And then things reflow to a three-column layout. Generally, once the viewport hits a maximum width, the columns hit a maximum size, and instead of getting wider, margins are added to the left and right. So how do we code this? Let's start with the smallest viewport. We have our three divs inside of a container div. The container is a flex container with flex wrap, wrap. Next, I've set the width of all of the divs to 100% to give me that stacked layout. Because this is just a sample, I'll pick a totally random breakpoint at 450 pixels. I want the dark blue div to be 25% of the viewport width, and the light blue div to be 75%. And I want to keep the green at the full width. I'm going to add a new media query that checks if min width is greater than or equal to 450 pixels, and then change the width of dark blue to 25 and light blue to 75%. I'll add a third breakpoint at 550 pixels and make the dark blue div 25%, the light blue div 50%, and the green div to be 25%. To get that to happen, I'll add a new media query that tests for a screen and min width 550 pixels. Inside that media query, I'll set the width for dark blue and green to 25% and light blue to 50%. Let's try it in the browser. We're all stacked at 400 pixels. At 450, our layout changes. And again, at 550 pixels. Perfect.